Hi, welcome to type 2 diabetes number 17. I'm Dr. Vladmir Carvalho and I'm an endocrinologist. Today, I'll answer a very simple question from a subscriber that wants to know if you can reverse prediabetes. Now, I had made a video before telling you that if you ask your doctor if you can cure type 2 diabetes, most doctors will say no. But if you say, can you reverse type 2 diabetes? Most of them will say yes. Now, of course, that has to be if you do it early enough that you still have enough functional beta cells. Now, if you wait for too long and all your beta cells are dead or dysfunctional, then you can't. But at early stage, you can. Now, if you look at prediabetes, which is even earlier than diabetes, that means that you can definitely reverse it. Now, prediabetes is a condition where your blood sugar is not normal. It's higher than normal, but it's not high enough for you to be diagnosed as diabetes, as type 2 diabetes. Now, your fasting blood sugar can be high, or if you do a glucose tolerance test, it can be abnormal, but not at the level where we can say you have diabetes. Or if you do an A1C test and it's higher than normal, but not high enough for you to be diagnosed as type 2 diabetes. Now, why do I say that you can definitely reverse prediabetes? Because for some of you following this channel, you know that when you eat, your blood sugar goes up, right? But you know that glucose is a big molecule. Glucose, sugar, cannot cross the membrane of the cells. So they cannot just come here and get in. They need special transporters. But for some cells, like muscle cells and fat cells, these transporters are inside the cells. And they need to wait for insulin to come and attach to the cells and tell the cells to bring the transporters to get glucose. Well, as I told you before, it's not like they just need to sit and wait. Glucose will get inside the beta cells of the pancreas and force them to release insulin. And this insulin can come and attach to these cells and tell them to bring the transporters and get glucose. And when this glucose gets inside the cells, they can be used for energy or they can be stored normally as glycogen and fat. Now, until here, everything is normal. But the problem is that now we have unlimited access to food, all kinds of unhealthy food, especially with a lot of sugars and refined carbs and, you know, things that can change quickly to glucose. When we keep overeating, especially these types of modern diet, you'll have a situation where your blood sugar keeps going up and all this extra glucose have to go to your beta cells of the pancreas and force them to release a lot of insulin. And all this insulin will attach to the cells and force the glucose transporters to come to the membrane and take a lot of glucose. Now, until here, it would still be okay if we were like back in the days where people used to work a lot, you know, because we were more active. And all this glucose would be used by muscle cells because muscle cells are the biggest glucose eaters. They can take a lot of glucose and burn them and use them for energy. But now we're not very active. So a lot of this glucose will go to fat cells and be stored as fat. And we keep getting bigger and bigger around, you know, our... And with time, as all this food is coming and all this glucose is forcing the beta cells to overwork and release a lot of insulin, the cells will start to resist this insulin. At one point, the cells will start to push back. Now, there are a lot of things that happen to these transporters and inside the cells for you to have insulin resistance. Maybe one day I'll make a video on it. But know that when all this glucose is coming, all this food is coming, forcing your beta cells of the pancreas to overwork and release all this insulin, your cells will start to resist insulin. That's what we call insulin resistance. And if we continue to do that, continue to make the beta cells of the pancreas to overwork, at some point, some of them will die or become dysfunctional. And you will end up with type 2 diabetes. When you are diagnosed with type 2 diabetes, about 50% of your beta cells are gone. Now, why do I say you can still reverse it? Because 50% is still enough. With half of your beta cells, if you take care of yourself early enough, you are still in time to just go back to having a normal life, you know? Which means that if you are here with what we call prediabetes, you are definitely fine. Because at this point, most of your beta cells are fine. Now, some studies will say that all your beta cells are fine. Some studies will even say that you have increased beta cell mass, maybe 10 to 15%, depending on the study. It doesn't matter too much if your beta cell mass is increased a little bit or not, you know, because you still have almost all your beta cells. And at this point, even if beta cell mass is increased or not, your beta cells are still releasing a lot of insulin. Normally, more than people without diabetes or prediabetes. So that means that here, at this stage, your beta cells are fine. They're overworking, but they are fine. So you have no problems here. Now, we're only left with two places where you can do something. Here, how much glucose you're putting in, and how much glucose is leaving to get inside the cells. Here, what do? Well, I can say you eat less, especially less things that raise your blood sugar. Things with high glycemic index or glycemic load. Glycemic load is more important, but you can watch the video if you want to understand it. But at the end of the day, you just need to make sure that there's less glucose coming from the food you eat. Now, I know that not everyone will change their diet, you know. One day I was talking to a patient that likes rice, and I told her, how many cups of rice do you eat? She said, 3. And I said, oh, with your blood sugar, if you reduce that 3 cups of rice to 1, you'll be fine. You know what she told me? She said, young man, I work all day. I don't have anything else to enjoy. When I go home, I want to enjoy my meal. And I said, well, you can eat other things. She said, if I don't eat my rice, I don't enjoy the meal at all, okay? So I'm not gonna start eating rice. You guys should give me something to fix my blood glucose. And we had to give her some medications that will reduce the amount of glucose that is coming inside. So for different people, different things work. But changing your diet and reducing the glucose that is coming from the food is definitely your best option. Now, the second place that we can look at is here. We need to find ways to get more glucose inside the cells. Now, the best way to do that is with exercise. Because during exercise, these transporters of glucose can move to the membrane, even if insulin is not here or is not enough. So when you're exercising and your muscles are working, there is a different mechanism that will take these glucose transporters to the membrane. That's why patients who are on insulin, when they're going to exercise, we tell them to reduce the amount of insulin they're taking because they might have hypoglycemia. Because insulin will put some of this glucose inside the cells, and exercise itself will also put some extra glucose inside the cells. Another reason we tell patients to exercise that I mentioned here is that I told you that at this stage, a lot of this glucose is going to your fat cells. When you exercise, you will have bigger muscles. You will change your body from this one to this one, and you will have bigger muscles. And these muscles can use a lot of that glucose. Most of that glucose will come here and be used for energy. Even if they're stored as glycogen, they will be used the next day. So more muscles, less fat, equals more glucose being used for energy. And again, I know that not everyone will exercise. There are some patients that there's nothing you can do to convince them to exercise. So they'll prefer to take some medications that will reduce this insulin resistance and make sure that the cells can use more glucose. But again, doing this with exercise is much better than doing it with medications. But just know that you have options. What you cannot do is just leave this glucose inside the blood. So today we have seen that when you eat, your blood sugar goes up, and this glucose gets inside the beta cells of the pancreas and force them to release insulin. And this insulin attached to different cells in your body, especially muscle cells and fat cells, and tell them to bring the transporters to the membrane so that they can take glucose. But if we keep overdoing it, especially with this modern lifestyle, at some point your cells will start to resist this insulin, and beta cells will have to overwork to compensate for that. And we know that when you have prediabetes, you are at a stage where you still have enough beta cells, sometimes more than enough. So if you take care of the amount of glucose that you're putting inside your body, and the amount of glucose that is getting inside different cells, you will be fine. Now, you can either do that with diet and exercise or medication. I prefer diet and exercise, but some patients prefer medications. That's why you see a lot of patients take medications like metformin that can reduce the amount of glucose that you're getting, and it can also reduce your insulin resistance and make more glucose get inside the cells. Metformin can also do other things like reducing the amount of glucose that your liver is producing, and you know, etc. But we'll talk about that when we talk about metformin. This is just an example. What medication you should take is between you and your doctor, okay? This channel is just for education. Now, there are some things that I didn't mention that can increase your risk of prediabetes. For example, if you're old, you know, if you're older than 45, but I don't think there's anything you can do about it. So, and if you have some diseases like PCOS, or you have high blood pressure or gestational diabetes before, or you have, you know, family members with diabetes, there are a lot of these things, but some of them you can't change, and some other diseases you might already know if you have or not. So if we take care of this one and this one, we should be fine. Have a blessed week. Bye.